XFM News. On point. Look at the news. Private schools under the umbrella body of Proprietors of Private Education Institutions Association Uganda have asked government to allow semi-candidate classes resume. During the launch of the association, the circle in Kampala today, the chairperson of the association, Chironde Mike, revealed that even though government allowed schools to reopen for candidate classes, they are finding it hard to finance school operations. Chironde attributes the financial difficulty to the low numbers of learners in the school.
We also request the government that having opened, the Honourable Minister, having opened P7, Senior 4, Senior 6, and we are 3 weeks successfully without any COVID issues, we request that they could do P6, and the S3 and S5 should be released to help us to start having some cash flow. Otherwise, so we request the ministry to continue looking into that, and we pledge that we shall take care of these children.
However, State Minister for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Mwingo, is calling on school owners to fulfill the set SOPs for the pilot phase before government moves on to reopen other classes.
While government is still keen on fully opening schools, the next steps to be taken greatly depend on the trend and the outcomes of this pilot. That's the pilot. You know what pilot means? Which in turn depends on your effectiveness in managing the situation. Some of you have, as according to Ms. Samulindo, who has visited, have performed very well. But the others who think that this is political are not enforcing the SOPs. According to those reports I'm getting.
The Electoral Commission has asked state-owned media houses to avail enough airtime to all presidential candidates as provided in the law. Presidential campaigns will kick off on Monday next week, and candidates are expected to use radios, TVs and other channels of communication to convert for votes under strict observance of the COVID-19 guidelines. The chairman of the commission, Simon Mujinyi-Byabakama, says the commission is engaging private media houses to also allow presidential candidates campaign via their media outlets.
For presidential candidates, the law is very clear. For state-owned media, they are under obligation to afford or accord each presidential candidate equal access to state-owned media. But for private media, even then, the private media, I think, do not operate in the wilderness. They are regulators. They have their own regulatory framework, which can also tow them in line. And therefore, we say there is need to engage with the NAB, National Association of Broadcasters, and other regulatory entities to make sure that the lives of presidential candidates are not made difficult as they go about canvassing for support from various parts of the country through the use of media.
Byabakama has, however, asked the presidential candidates to follow their campaign program to avoid collusion.
The candidates need to, as much as possible, follow the schedule. As I said, one of the purposes of having a harmonized campaign schedule program is to avoid the candidates' programs clashing, being in the same place, the same district, same venue, same time. And then you have the supporters who take their support to another level, you know, bordering on enmity. And then we say, to avoid these potential clashes, let them stick to the schedules that will have been worked out or agreed upon as much as possible for the good of everyone.
NRM political activists, the Yellow Thumb Initiative, have warned young people against politicians who mobilize them to engage in riots. The national coordinator, Yellow Thumb Initiative, Mohammed Badger, says politicians with selfish interests tend to exploit the youth during campaigns. He said this while launching the association in Kampala.
To the so-called youth, we believe that we should use a lot of energy. That is one, a wrong approach. Two, we should not be willing to work at whatever scenarios. But we are calling upon the youth that as Yellow Thumb, we've come out to make sure that we unite ourselves, form ourselves, or organize ourselves to be better off and perform better in the job section. So in this other aspect of human rights can be violated if you're not respecting other person's human rights.
Daniel Kaziwe, a.k.a. Ragadi, the NRM party flag bearer for Kampala Lord Mayor position, who was the guest of honor, retaliated the need for mindset change among the young people, which would engage in incoming generating activities. I beg your pardon, in income generating activities instead of listening to selfish politicians.
We need what we need in Uganda today. We need mindset changing. So many people have a different mindset about everything. So many people don't know nothing about Kampala. But it's good that this team is here. I would like everyone in Uganda to know that I'm ready to work with them. I want His Excellency, the President of Uganda, our chairman, to understand that this is a very strong team, but we need proper youth that understand the real, the core problems of the youth that can explain the reality.
In other news, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi is facing tough questions about her ability to win enough votes to retain her leadership after Democrats shrunk their House majority and moderates in the party plotted to back a challenger. Democrats went into Tuesday night expecting to pad their majority in the House by marching deeper into President Donald Trump's 2016 win territory, but instead Republicans made gains. Already two centrist Democrats in the House say they are contacting colleagues to round up support for House Democratic Caucus Chairman Hakeem Jeffries atop Pelosi lieutenant for Speaker in the next Congress, according to The Hill. Several moderate House Democrats only won tough re-elections after vowing not to back Pelosi for another term as Speaker, and they view Jeffries as a potential establishment leader who could garner support from representatives Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez's powerful squad of progressives. He bridges moderates and progressives better than anyone. And most importantly, he's not Nancy Pelosi, one Democratic lawmaker told The Hill of Jeffries. He's the only one prepared and positioned to be Speaker. All four members of Ocasio-Cortez's squad won re-election, and the faction added three new progressive allies in districts in Missouri and New York. In entertainment news, part-time Trump troller John Legend strikes again on the Grammy-winning artist mocked the president for claiming a series of victories in undecided battleground states. Trump tweeted, "We have claimed for electoral votes, vote purposes, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, which won't allow legal observers, the state of Georgia and the state of North Carolina, each one of which has a big Trump lead. Additionally, we hereby claim the state of Michigan." Legend, who has been an outspoken critic of Trump, responded to the flagged tweet in a facetious way. He called on Twitter users to claim things they do not have any right to, thus underscoring the meaninglessness of Trump's declaration. "To be clear, you have to say hereby to make it legally binding," Legend added. The responses immediately flooded in with participants claiming everything from large bank balances to private islands to celebrity crushes. And that was the news.